Welcome back to Exotic Wine Travel. I am your host, Matthew Horky. Welcome back to the show. I'm sorry if there's going to be a little bit of background noise. I'm outside. I thought it'd be a nice day. I'm near the street, so you're going to hear some cars going by and everything. I hope that's mitigated. But today we're going to talk about reds and navigating the reds in Valpolicella. So reds from Valpolicella are from Veneto. Veneto is the most productive wine region in Italy. Valpolicella reds and Suave whites are some of the most exported wines in all of Italy. So we're going to go through these. These can be very delicious wines made from Corvina, Corvenone, Rondinella, and Molinera. My Italian is not that great, so these are the types of grapes that make up the blend. And you're going to see several different categories. You know, most people, when they go to Veneto, they want to chase the big, powerful Amarones. Amarones are grapes that are wines that are made by grapes that are harvested, then sun-dried, so the grapes shrivel, concentrate. Then they make the wine. The wines become big, powerful, 15, 16, 17% alcohol. Rich, full of tobacco, earthy, dried cherry and plum notes, things that people really like. But really the bread and butter of Valpolicella are Valpolicella reds. Now historically, Valpolicella is a cooler region, so the reds were a little bit thinner. That's why they had to come up with Amarone style of wines. But there's a lot more to the region than just Amarone. And let's talk about some of those wines today. Luckily, we have some wines, the whole lineup from Villa Canestrati. We met them at a business-to-business tasting. They're nice enough to pass us some samples. So we're going to illustrate the wines using their lineup. So let's get started. You know, at the very basic level, you're going to see wines that are called Valpolicella Rosso. And those are blends. These are going to be thin, just everyday cup of red wines, usually not that expensive. One thing that you also need to know about these wines, you can see Valpolicella Classico on the label. That just means they're grown within a smaller area, the original area from which Valpolicella wines come from. They've expanded the area because the wines had so much commercial success. So the zone is bigger, there's more vineyards, there's more wine to go around. The next step up from Valpolicella Reds, you're going to see other things like Ripasso Superiore. So what does that stuff kind of mean? Well, let's get into it first of all. First of all, we have the Villa Canestrati e Lassi Valpolicella Ripasso Superiore from 2016. Now, what are Ripasso wines? Ripasso wines are Valpolicella Reds. What they do is they take the skins from Amarone wines once they're finished. They throw them back into the Valpolicella red batch. The wines ferment again, so you get a richer, stronger wine than just a Valpolicella kind of classic style wine. They're not as big as Amarone's, but they do have richness. I've had this wine before. I really, really enjoy it. With these wines, you get a little bit of cherry and just a touch of tobacco, not full-on tobacco like you get for Amarone wines. Cherry. Fall leaves, touch of a tobacco, earth. These wines are medium to full body, lots of texture, lots of red fruit, lots of earthiness. Fans of Central Italian, when I compare them, they're kind of like Sangiovese-based wines, but Veneto wines tend to be a little bit more black cherry, whereas Sangiovese tends to be more sour cherry. I think this Ilassi wine is very good. The Ilassi Ripasso, I'm going to give it 90 points. I thought it was good when I tasted it in the business-to-business tasting. I think it's very good when I'm tasting it now. Oh, excellent wine. Let's move on, shall we? Next, we have the Villa Canestrati Valpolicella Superiore 2016. Now, what's interesting, when you see Superiore on these wines, you know, they have longer aging requirements. The wines have to be a little bit more concentrated because there's yield management that comes into play. But for some producers like Canestrari, with their Valpolicella, they're actually making this like an Amarone. So what happens is these grapes get dried for anywhere from 20 to 40 days. The grapes shrivel, concentrate, dehydrate. They become darker, denser, richer in sugar. Make wines. This wine turns out to be 14.5 alcohol, whereas opposed to Amarone wines where the grapes are dried from anywhere from 3 months to 4 months in the case of these wines. So I have not tasted this wine. This is the 2016. Let's see how it tastes compared to the Ripasso. off the bat, you're going to get just a touch, not a little, not a ton, just a touch of darker fruit. Dark cherry, red plum. There is a little more concentration, a little bit more tobacco notes, a little bit of menthol. This wine's slightly fuller in body, just a tad bit richer. You've got a little bit more tannins, a little bit more concentration. I think that a lot of people are going to like this wine. I'm going to score it also 90 points and for my palate. Personally, I prefer to drink the Rapasso style wine. It's just a tad lighter, tad juicier, a tad more food friendly. But I think a lot of people that don't want to spring and spend the big time money for Amarones are going to like these superior style wines that are baby Amarones, Amarone-like. And then lastly, in the Valpolicella Reds, you're going to have Amarones or Amarone Reservas that are aged a little bit longer. This is Canastrori's top wine, the 1888 Amarone della Valpolicella Reserva 2012, clocks in at 16.5 alcohol. It's a big boy. And they've started to make this new wine, just the Amarone della Valpolicella 2016. They wanted to make this. This is dried on the grapes are dried for 3 months. These are going to be easier Amarones that you can drink more than one glass. Sometimes Amarones become so thick and powerful, one glass is enough for me. So, yeah, check it out. Let me know, you know. Are you guys drinking a lot of Veneto wines? Are you drinking some of the Rapassos, the Valpolicella Superiores? Or you always go straight for Amarone? Let me know in the comments below. So guys, if you like this video, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, Exotic Wine Travel. I will see you at the next episode.